Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to do something that's going to be a little bit out of my comfort zone, something that I've never tried. So wish me luck. Anyway, so I have Hanna Karlzon's book, Tales from the Forest Kingdom here, and I really have been wanting to do this page. To me, this, I don't know if you are familiar with the book and was later made into a movie by C.S. Lewis, The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe, but this guy right here just screams Mr. Tumnus to me. And let me see if I can get a picture here on my iPad and show you if you're not familiar with who he is or what the character is. Hold on. Okay, so I have a big picture pulled up here. This is what he looks like in the character in the movie, and you can see that he is, I guess, what they call a fawn. So where he's like part, I don't know if it's part goat, I should have looked it up, part goat or and part human. Anyway, I just love this character in this movie slash book. Anyway, so I thought this guy is definitely got to be him. So what I am attempting to do here is I have already started by whiting out the lines here. I want to turn this collar of this shirt into a scarf like you see him wearing here, a red scarf. So that's what I'm going to try to do. So I'm going to try, I'm not the best sketcher in the world by any means, but I'm going to try to just kind of sketch a simple scarf just right here. At least I don't have to make a very big area. And then I'll come back and we'll start coloring. All right. Okay, so I used Posca to white out the lines the best I could. And like I said, I am by no means a sketch artist at all. So it does look pretty rough. I just tried to draw some folds here, like it's fabric. I don't know if I am going to actually be able to make it look like a knit scarf. I tried to make lines like the actual knit stitches and stuff in here, but it just didn't look right. So I might just have to make it just a basic red scarf. Anyway, I'm not sure how to make it look knitted. So anyway, yeah, so this is a major challenge for me with trying to do this scarf. And also, I've never colored a man before. So this ought to be interesting. But I have this great reference photo. So that's what I'm going to be looking at. Okay, so right away, I just wanted to tell you that I did experience problems coloring over that white Posca. So if you would want to hold off on doing that part of the page, I totally recommend that. That way you can see if that is something that you want to go through with, because I also did end up using a red paint pen to cover up the white areas that the Posca had left, where I was having problems covering over that. So that is in part two. And if nothing else, you can at least use this tutorial for everything except for his shirt. Also, I'd like to add that I don't know if you can see right there, along where his ear starts into in his hairline, I have extended his hair to cover that bottom part of the ear. The way the line work looked originally was kind of off to me, so I just went ahead and covered up the bottom part of his ear by extending that lock of hair.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.